files and you know, non-CAD documentation on 3D space app of the platform. We use the maturity states to control if a particular document or a part file or a drawing is being worked or if it's released. This kind of helps us to understand what is the latest revision or what is the latest state of a drawing or a file. So prior to using the platform, revision control was basically renaming your part file to be revision 1.1, 1.2. There were instances where there was a final revision, then there was a final revision. So we were using computers, but it felt like we were using Stone Age technology just to manage revisions. When you're working with a complex product like ours, it is very important that you stay on top of the changes. And changes can come from a lot of places. It can come from your shop floor, it can come from the designers, or it can even come from your customers. So it is then important to understand how easy or how difficult it is for you to change something in the system and how a simple change affects every other thing, be it in your assembly or be it in your processes. Platform interface was based out of a browser, so it brings in familiarity of the browser to your day-to-day interaction with it. One of the things that I really enjoyed was, you know, giving access to the platform to other non-CAD users in the company who needed to be a part of the platform because, you know, they do so much with the data that is on there. And I didn't really have to hold their hand and teach them. I just had to send them a link where, you know, they created their user credentials and they started using the system like pros from day one.
Do you want to know how many SOLIDWORKS files are sent all over the world each year, soaring from email to email via attachments and FTP sites? Or how many SOLIDWORKS files have been saved to temperamental network drives or local disk space on a coworker's laptop? Or what about how many coffee-stained change action forms are sitting in a filing cabinet somewhere, collecting dust in a room hardly anyone ventures into anymore? All right, so listen, I'll break character, you get the point, and so do we. Look, I don't have great answers from the swaths of untracked instances accounting for literally any of the questions that I just posed, and hey, I'm sorry about that. But what I do know is that you are here, and you're watching this video about activating and getting started with cloud services so that you can make one or all of those things I mentioned a distant memory using something that actually comes with each new seat of SOLIDWORKS on subscription. You know, during our latest What's New in SOLIDWORKS yearly presentation, which by the way, regularly attracts over 100,000 viewers across YouTube and LinkedIn, probably the most asked about aspect of the software was actually cloud services. So without further ado, let's take a look at how to activate and get started with cloud services for SOLIDWORKS with a little help from one of my friends here at SOLIDWORKS, SOLIDWORKS expert, Todd Troutt. Todd, let's start with the basics as we get started here, and let's do a little bit of rapid fire. All right, what is cloud services for SOLIDWORKS exactly?
Now, it's the exact same version that you're used to as far as SOLIDWORKS, but you get the add-in that connects that to the 3D Experience platform. And you get other tools that are part of 3D Experience that you run in your browser.
So if I'm following you closely here, it's the same SOLIDWORKS that we know and love as designers, right? But with cloud services for SOLIDWORKS, every new license can connect to the 3D Experience platform, which sounds great, but what does that actually mean? You know, in other words, what does this empower me to do if I'm a SOLIDWORKS user with this newfound connection to this cloud area you're talking about?
Yeah, you really hit the nail right on the head there. As far as all new licenses with subscription get cloud services along with their SOLIDWORKS license. And so there's a ton you can do with SOLIDWORKS and cloud services, but how about we go through the first basic steps of getting started, getting everything, you know, hooked up and everything, and then we'll go through some of the tools together. So right off the bat, here's the thing. You're going to want to look out for an email from Deso Systems. Do you see that button that just scrolled by? It says launch your 3D Experience platform. Okay, when you click on that, it's going to take you to the login. Now, as a brand new customer, you just need to set up your 3D Experience ID. So go through these basic kind of steps. We've all done this, right? Just set up your email, name, and password. This is one of these real key screens, but it's just going to say, hey, when you click this, you're going to become the administrator for your platform. You want to make sure that if you're a single user and you know, you've bought SOLIDWORKS with cloud services, you're going to be your administrator for your usage, okay? So once you log in, then you're going to get your close agreement. You can scroll through and read this. You can download the agreement if you want to. But you get to the end and you accept the agreement. And then this logs you in and launches you into the platform management section of 3D Experience. So that's the activation process. And that's really all there is to it.
All right, let's say, for example, you know, I bought 3 licenses of SOLIDWORKS and I'm the admin of my cloud area. So once I'm up and running, how do I invite my colleagues to our new cloud space so that we can share and access files together?
So I'm in the platform management dashboard, logged in as the administrator. And here you get to see your members and your roles, or basically your licenses for cloud services. If I go right here to this members tab, you'll have all the stuff that you can see as far as your members and the licenses. Now, if you're a single user, you have one license for cloud services. When you log in, you're going to have all the roles that you need automatically assigned to you. If there's more, you know, colleagues that you need to invite, you do that here. We click on the invite members tab, right? It's pretty straightforward, and you just add their email and then go through and assign the licenses as needed.
So is there any software that we need to install to begin using cloud services for SOLIDWORKS? And of course, if so, where do we go to get it?
Well, as we said, right, it's the same SOLIDWORKS desktop CAD that you're used to. So the first thing is to go ahead and install that like you always have.
Okay. And then on your 3D Experience platform, you want to go to this hamburger menu up in the upper left. And you're going to have your dashboards or your home pages here. Go to that collaborative designer for SOLIDWORKS dashboard. There's an install button right there for design with SOLIDWORKS. Okay, that is the add-in that you need to install. So just click on that button. It's a real quick install, and that's the piece of software that you have to install. Now, once you're done with the install, it changes over to an open button. And you want to click on that open to launch your SOLIDWORKS for the first time once you install the add-in. That just makes the connection between SOLIDWORKS and the 3D Experience platform.
Todd, from what I've seen, one of the most popular features that we're introducing with cloud services for SOLIDWORKS is the new design sharing and markup capabilities. So can you give us just a bit of an overview of what's being offered here?
Yeah, I think we've all been at the point while we're working on a design and we just need to show someone where we're at with that design.
Yeah, maybe it's, you know, a coworker or your customer maybe, and you're going to do a bit of a design review on your work, or maybe it's a supplier and you want to, you know, get a quote on something or get some feedback before you get that quote on how they're going to make it. The sharing and markup tools that cloud services opens up, it lets you send your 3D model and lets those folks look at it right in their browser without installing any software, no downloads. And then they can also mark that up and do some really cool things with it and provide that feedback without passing these emails back and forth, that kind of thing.
All right, well, hey, look, it looks and sounds awesome, but can you maybe show us how to set up these new sharing and markup features with cloud services?
Yeah, back in the 3D Experience platform in your browser, go to the platform management dashboard. You want to run over here to the content tab.
This is just a bunch of settings that are available. We'll go to share with external. And this toggle right here to allow platform members to share content with external users by link. That's off by default. Turn that on to allow this share and markup capability. And then the next one as well, turn that on to allow these external users to view and then make those comments on that shared content. That's all there is to setting it up.
We've heard, of course, a lot about how easy the workflow of sharing projects for viewing and markup purposes has become with cloud services for SOLIDWORKS. But Todd, can we actually go through an example together of how this can prove useful to SOLIDWORKS users?
Here I am. I've got SOLIDWORKS open and a subassembly that I've been working on. And from my command manager, notice I've got a lifecycle and collaboration tab. That's where the share a file tool is. So just go to that tab. And I'm going to start off by showing you a couple options. In the drop down here, you can select which format you want to share. Okay, the 3D XML, that may be new to you. That is basically the full 3D version that you'll be able to view in the browser. It is worth noting that these other formats, it's going to allow the recipient to download those if they need to. And another way that you may be able to exchange those neutral file formats. So we're going to keep it as the 3D XML because that's a super lightweight 3D version that's not going to bog down everything if you've got even the largest assemblies. So we'll keep that as our option. And then we'll click on share a file. Once that file gets generated, there's a couple of toggles here that will switch on and put your email address in. So we're going to do it as an external sharing link and enable the comments and then restrict access to only the people that get this email that I'm typing in here. And then we can put a custom message, right? So we're just gonna say, take a look at my design. And then we click the share button. Two things are happening right here. One is I get to see in my task pane the file that was generated. The other thing that's happened is you're getting an email sent. So why don't we take a look and see what that looks like and see the side of it as the recipient. So again, the person getting this share email, they don't have to have any license. They don't have to buy anything at all. If you don't have one already, they'll just be asked to create a 3D Experience ID and to log in. On my session back in SOLIDWORKS here, I'm gonna go over to the task pane, and this is our 3D Experience tab in the task pane. And when I click on that, I can see that I've got a notification. This is gonna show me that Sean O'Neill made a comment on my file, right? So let's see what that looks like. I'm gonna click on that in my task pane here. I'm gonna expand it. I like to use this right here. That shows the same 3D view and your comment, right? So it's like, please see comment. We need to get a through cut in there. Beautiful, right? It's really cool just to kind of get in there and play around, because if there's other views that you want to add comments and markups, add comments as you want to. So now I've got your feedback and I can send that back to you and you'll be able to pull that up, see the updated model and add more comments.
Todd, let's talk about using tools within cloud services as a means to store our CAD data. Now, this is, of course, an option that our users with cloud services have, but I could see many of our users seeing this as a safe, secure alternative to storage versus what they might be using today, whether that's locally or through some other cloud service. So can you take us through maybe a quick demo of how to just do the basics, even just save a file to this new cloud area?
Here I've got an assembly open, and let's say we want to now store this on the 3D Experience platform on the cloud. I like to go over here to the task pane at the 3D Experience tab, and this gives me the status of what I'm looking at on the screen. Okay, this is my session. This is just my assembly and all the files. This file's not yet been saved to the 3D Experience. It's really super simple. Just right click on this assembly and I'm gonna say save with options. Okay, that's gonna launch the dialog to save it to the platform. You're gonna be able to access that from anywhere. You're able to easily collaborate with others on that from, you know, within your company that also have access to the files on the platform, and it's safe and secure. That's huge, right? Now, one thing I want to recommend and show you right quick is to set up a bookmark for our files. Bookmarks are essentially a lot like folders. They're actually a lot more powerful, but for a starter, I just want to say it gives you that look and feel of folders, okay? So as we get started here, I don't have any bookmarks. I can create one from the fly. From the bookmarks selection here, I'm going to say, let's make a new bookmark, and we'll just apply that to all. And we're going to hit save. It's really that simple.
We just saw how we were able to save an assembly to 3D Experience, but of course, you know, once I've saved my project up to the cloud, how do I go about retrieving it and opening it within SOLIDWORKS?
So you'll start where you think you'd start. You go to the open button or file open. And here you see a button that's a toggle to open from 3D Experience. And remember those bookmarks we set up? Well, that's again your organization. Now you see that you've got thumbnails and all the descriptions and metadata and everything in here, but you can go up to the search as well. And we'll type in the description that we had for that one. We see we've got several that match that search. We can also use the quick filters that are down at the bottom. Now over here in the my session, I'm gonna sort based on the ones that I have locked. Those are the only two that I need to change. And we're gonna do a right click and say new revision. So you're gonna see we're gonna create the new revision. We'll go ahead and put our note in here because this is gonna be for documentation later saying like what we're gonna change. And we're gonna put that hole in for visibility. And we'll have this version B of the assembly and the part, and it's locked, so no one else can step on our toes. So we're gonna make that change. Take a look at it here, does that look good? I think it looks pretty good. You can see right in there. And yeah, so now we need to save that. So what I like to do is go over here and we can just select the assembly and we'll say save with options. Now that similar dialogue that we saw before, those are the ones that are gonna be bumped, rev, and saved. We click save. Now they're going to the platform on the cloud. So we got the new revision. And I check the box in the dialog to save so that it's unlocked as I save it.
Thanks for watching, everyone. You know, with this activation and getting started video of cloud services for SOLIDWORKS, we've essentially shown you just that, which is how to activate and get started. Meaning there is so much more to uncover, including some pretty amazing and easy to use design management and change features that are also natively available within cloud services for SOLIDWORKS. So if you're interested in any of what you saw today, you can find out more about all of what we've shown by going here. We can't wait to see how much more time you have for design by empowering you and your teams with cloud services for SOLIDWORKS, which, by the way, once again, is available within each new seat of SOLIDWORKS on subscription today.